Hi, I'm Sam Foster, an R&D engineer with Keysight Technologies, and today I'll be talking about the I-squared T test. Now before I go ahead and jump in and show you how to run this test, I'll go over a few basics of what the I-squared T test is. The I-squared T is a test that shows the energy in a current inrush transient, and it's important because if you don't size your fuses properly to the I-squared T value, your fuse could blow every time you turn on your device. And that can go from annoying to quite unacceptable, as some fuses are quite in the depths of your device or on a printed circuit board somewhere. I'll explain my test setup here quickly. I have a function generator hooked up to the external current transducer input on the first channel of the power analyzer. And it's set up to input a 10 amp, 16 millisecond square pulse. This will be perfect for running the I-squared T test. Now to get started, simply click on Analyze and change your analysis to I-squared T. And here come up a few parameters for us to set. The current source is what we'll be doing the I-squared T test on. The expected peak will be at least at or above the inrush current peak that you're expecting. Since I have a 10 amp peak, I'll set that to 10.5 just to be a little bit higher and to set the hardware range. The inrush trigger is the current level of which the test will trigger off of. I'll set that to 1 amp. And the acquisition time will be the test time across the full screen. I have 16 millisecond pulse, so I'll set that to 20 millisecond to ensure that I catch the whole inrush. Hitting start here, you'll be prompted a few things. It'll first tell you to turn off the power supply and click next. That's to make sure that the box is ready to capture your inrush. Clicking next, it'll tell you to turn on the power supply and notice that the box went into single mode. I'll go ahead and trigger my inrush now. And you see that we've captured it. Clicking next after that, two math waveforms come up. The lighter pink trace is the I squared, and you can see it's just a larger value of the inrush current. The purple trace is the integral of I squared, which is I squared T. And you can see the energy rising throughout the inrush and capping out there. Numbers populate the sidebar here, but before we interpret them, it's important to set the start and stop time of your transient. Now, there's no magic way to set the start and stop. It's really up to you and your device. So I'll go ahead and keep my X2 here at the start of the square pulse and move my X1 to the end of the square pulse. And you can notice, as I change the cursor value, the sidebar numbers also update. The top number is the I squared T. We have 1 amp squared seconds. The peak current is the peak of your current transient at 10.39 amps. And the start time and the end time refer to these cursors respectively, and the transient time is just the difference between them. That's all I have for you today on the I-squared T-test. Thank you so much for watching.